So for today's video, I'm talking this way because that way you guys can see it. We are going to see what I look like with a baby face. Now, you guys have not ever seen me without some kind of facial hair. So we're going to change that today, and you guys get to see what it looks like to have baby face Justin. See how it goes. First, I'm going to take off some of the excess. That way, it's easier to shave so I actually get into it. For that, I'm going to use an electric razor. Now, during the quarantine, I have not done much of anything when it comes to facial hair. I did clean it up once because of engagement pictures with Carly, which some of those are posted on Facebook. We have more in a little gallery. If you want some of the pictures from that gallery, text me. I'd be willing to send that link to you all. Who am I to be blind, pretending not to see them? Look at this. That's just from the electric razor. I actually gotta sweep this up. I don't like having excessive amounts of hair go down the drain. Next. No place to go. That's why I want you to know. I'm starting with the man in the mirror. And I'm asking him to change his ways. And no message could have been any clearer. If you want to make the world a better place, take a look at yourself and the man that changed. A way that I learned to shave is, you know, to pass the time, to help me actually remember stuff. It was actually from my Greek class back in the day. We were taught to to conjugate verbs, specifically I am, which is, you know, you do it while you're shaving. Erkamai, lusamai, aelthon, aleilutha. Erkamai, lusamai, aelthon, aleilutha. It was like, basically means like, I am, I was, I have been, and another one that, but maybe you could come up with a different song to sing during your quarantine shaving time. Ladies, I know you shave too, just not your face, usually. I don't know, but my sisters would shave their legs all the time. You guys can make up a song to help you learn something while you're doing it. For me, it's the verbs of I am in Greek. Erkamai, lusamai, aelthon, aleilutha. Erkamai, lusamai, aelthon, aleilutha. This is also a great place. I've seen a lot of people do it. They have like little post-it notes right here. Where they write a Bible verse. That's a great way to pass the time as well, is learn some scripture. And just memorize some scripture while you're doing things that are in your normal daily routine that you have to do anyway, but kind of redeeming that time a little bit. And one of the reasons why Erkamai is so important. Wait, I just realized, Erkamai is like to go, it's not to be, that's I me, unless Erkamai is conjugated that way. It's been a while, don't tell my Greek professors, I can't remember it right now. One of the most important reasons why that verb to be is so important in the Bible is actually because that's God's name, is Yahweh, which translates as I am. So that's why we call God the great I am,
Because whenever he talked to Moses, Moses was like, who am I supposed to say sent me? And God answered, I am what I am, or who I am. I am that I am. So the people called him Yahweh, which means I am. So that verb is so important, and we see it in the Greek a lot whenever Jesus makes statements about who he is. In one of the stories of Jesus is the Pharisees ask him, like, who are you? And he just says, I am. And they all, like, stumble back. I'm pretty sure this is in the narrative when he is being betrayed by Judas, actually. I'm gonna have to double check that after I'm done. But he says, I am. And they stagger back because he just used the name of God. Just a little cool story while I'm shaving. And now you all get to see
what I look like when I was back in high school.
Thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Just a little time where we can talk and you guys get to see what I look like if I were a baby. But as always, may your hearts be full and your day be bright.